up, guys? Gaming Rebate here. Not Gaming Rebate, I mean Gamer X, guys. I don't like to say Gaming Rebate that much. I like to say Gamer X because, yeah. And today we have a rather different video, and I don't really want to stare much to the camera because the light is on and I have terrible lighting in my room right now. But luckily I have a flashlight on my phone, which I can do stuff with. Hey, I hope you can see me. You probably can. But we're going to do a review on the Razer RX 200 scooter right here, and my friend gave this to me. It was used. Yeah, it's pretty good. As you can see, it is fully running. This is not a clickbait video. Obviously, it is fully running. I can throw it a little for you too, guys. It's pretty aggressive when there's nothing on it. This thing, if you do put a load on it, if you do put something fake on it, if you do put like a mini load on it, you... Sorry if I'm covering the camera, guys. I'm trying to adjust my screw here. And yeah, here's the brakes. It's a disc brake, as you can see right here. And if you guys want to get a close-up of how it works, because I did a video earlier yesterday. Right, here we are. You can see that little pad over there just pushing against it. And it works the same as this. Okay, guys, forget it. I'm not gonna make that boring. But, oops. As you can see right here, as soon as I pushed that, a car alarm went off. I don't know if you guys could hear that. Or heard that. It's sort of hard to push for some reason. It's not really. But you can pull this cable. This cable here, it pulls it. It's a pretty simple mechanism. This is how bike brakes work when they're on disc. It's literally like this. Bike brakes have this type of disc, and then they have a pad in between them, and then they just stop, which is pretty simple. Now, saying the fact that this actually, I think, weighs like 50 pounds, over 50 pounds, I think. The fact that my friend and I can lift it, it's crazy. But this, I'm gonna take out this morning and just ride it around the grass and around where I live, because it's a battery. It comes with two terrible lead-acid batteries. It lasts like half an hour, and then it goes away. It takes 3 hours to charge. It's not that powerful. It doesn't go that fast. Here there are the cables that go from everything into there. It goes to the control unit. And here are the tires. These things are meant for off-roading, even though the scooter needs a more powerful motor. Actually, it's good. It can off-road, but it needs a more powerful motor and a little bigger and long-lasting battery, so you can stay like outside for longer. Now, I was thinking of making this gas-powered, but it's insanely complicated. It's like it's a lot of work. If you guys like look at it, like you have to take out the controller, you have to take out the motor, you have to take out the batteries. And you're gonna have to make brackets back here, which is not, I don't really find so difficult. But like, if you really want to do this, what you have to do is you also have to cut a piece out from right. Is this zoomed in? Okay, no. It looks like it. You would have to cut a piece from here. You would have to shorten it that way. You could probably just cut a little hole like right over here, so that way the chain from the motor can go to the wheel if you mount it up here. So that way you could just spin it, and then I think this throttle. I don't know if it's good enough. It's a piece of trash. Scooter's still on. The throttle here, as you can see, it probably would work if you just do this, because it'll just speed up the engine casually. If not, if you hold it, then just speeds up casually, then that's good, but, yeah. And the brakes are fine on this thing. This is the type of brakes that you would expect on a scooter like this. Now, no front brakes, because, there's no need for front brakes, because you could fall on your face if you do front brakes. There's a need for back brakes because this is where all the transmits happen with it. Now, this is not there used to be electric scooters where you had to push one, where you push down and it stopped, but those ones are older models. This is the newer model with the disc brake.
Now, the slightly older model from this one was actually a model that had a bike brakes, like little pads that would squeeze these from both sides, kind of like this. And at this point, they're like go-karts with drum brakes. Well, most of them probably do have drum brakes. And there are scooters with like mini drum brakes also, just so you don't have to stress out. But drum brakes are sort of complicated. So, yeah. Now, as you can see, these things run on disc. It's such a short distance between them. And as I pull it, you can see that moving up there. And I have no idea. There's a cable that connects to nothing up here. See this cable? This cable connects to nothing. There's a cable that connects to nothing. As you can see, it says twist. So it's kind of like an on and off, which would work alright, I guess, but I would say it's not the best throttle for this. But this, I'm just planning on putting a better speed controller, a better motor, basically just gutting the whole thing from the inside over here, and putting a better motor, a better battery, obviously, like probably like a friggin' 24, really like huge, like 36 volt battery, a 48 volt motor, which actually they say goes 30 miles an hour, put a powerful motor on this thing, put the gear from this motor, same chain, and then we'll have a scooter that is better with a better speed controller. Now, I can get a more variable scooter speed controller. I can get the same type, but like a more powerful, like more like high voltage, like 36 voltage speed controller or something. 40, I don't know, expensive, but if it's like too much, then I'll just stick with 36. If I can go 40 or 48 volt, I'll do that and put like a powerful, like 36 volt battery in there, something like that. Put a more powerful motor. Possibly 3,200 RPM, 3,000, 4,000 RPM. I don't know what type of motor I'll put in there. But I saw a motor on eBay that's fast. I need like a 36 volt motor, 48 volt motor. And the motor's actually under here. This is the kickstand right here that holds, I don't even know how it holds this 50 pounds. But like, yeah, as you can see, guys, I have the light on. It probably kind of looks weird, to be honest with you, because you can kind of see my shadow on the ground extended. Oh my god, the camera doesn't pick that up, does it? Alright, so without the light, I would be recording like this, guys. But I don't want bad lighting, so I like to use the flashlight when there's bad lighting. Now, under here, yeah, I tried opening this yesterday. I can't open it. Like, I literally can't open it. Like, the speed controller, it's right here with all the cables connected. You have your two lead-acid batteries right here, and then you have your motor mount right there. And then you just have your brakes and then your wheels under here, and then you have your chain right over here with the gear. And it's very weird mountage inside there. As you can see, it has a connection all the way down there. Holy crap. As you can see, there's a little wheel over there. I don't know if you guys can see that. But it's a pretty long chain. What I'm thinking of doing, if this ever gets into a gas-powered project, I don't know, I highly doubt it, just make it more powerful, I guess. But if it ever does get into a gas-powered project, I'll just mount an engine up here. Wherever the crankshaft is, I'll just dig a hole through here, put the fin chain through here, and just on the gear, another gear from the crankshaft, and or from a type of variable transmission or whatever. So that way, like, your wheel doesn't spin whenever the crankshaft spins. But I think it can hold the brakes. I don't know if that's going to break the engine, but, like, holding it for a short time, I highly doubt it will. But, yeah, if I could just do that, this thing would go 30. I think it's a lot, I don't know, a lot faster than it is right now. Because, like, I can't really record one-handedly. I need something, like, I need, like, a mount. I could make a cheap setup with a little bit of duct tape, like guys, on the live right here, like, I can put, like, a setup of duct tape, and I can just tape it to, like, a helmet or something. Or, no, I could just put it on the screen like this, but, yeah. I don't know how I'd, show my finger in between there like that. This video was mostly on cuts, because I didn't really have to open anything. But yeah, this is a pretty simple setup. My friend gave it to me used. He used it a lot, actually, before, but, like, he doesn't even care about it anymore because he was thinking he was going to get a pit bike, but sadly there's laws and all that stuff. And I told him that those laws aren't really true. Like, kids can ride it under their parents', like, authority and all that stuff. Well, obviously you can. Like, I live in the state of Michigan. I don't know if, like, rules here, like... Ugh. These brakes are a bit hard to pull because actually these are disc brakes and these are like mini brake drums right here. If it'll focus. Okay, I'm sorry, I won't focus, guys. Okay, I think I just focused. Just quality's not that good. So like if you hold this, like just holds the disc obviously. But, like, the brake pad is still really good in it. The kickstand is still really good. My friend has kept this in good condition. I'm good with it. And as you can see, I tried to clean off a little bit over here. I tried to clean this off, but it's a bit dirty over here. So I'm just going to have to deal with it. But, yeah. So that's about it, guys. I forgot to do the intro subscribe thing, but if you enjoyed the video, subscribe and turn on that bell notification. Subscribe to join the Gamers X. And don't forget to hit that bell button so you don't miss any of my latest videos. And like the video. 5 to 10 likes if possible, that'd be nice. At least 5 or 10 if I can get that. I don't know. I'll try getting something to work out today. I'm sorry if I look lazy. It's literally 9:54 in the morning, guys. And I didn't wake up too long ago, so I'm still... I did go to the bathroom. I didn't really wash my face, so I'm probably just going to go get to that right now. So that's about it for today's video, guys. I'll see you with another video. I'll probably try to do a cheap setup on a helmet so I can record this for you guys. And let's hope it doesn't fall off my helmet, and let's hope I don't run over it. Because if I do run over my phone, I don't know if I really get affected, but it probably will because of how heavy the scooter is. But, like, I don't know. Would it get affected? Probably not. If it falls backwards, then that'd be a lucky thing. But, like, luckily my case is, like... That's my case right there, guys. You can probably hear it. It's, like... It's literally rubber and plastic combined in a very solid formation. It was a $25 case. I'm not gonna lie. That's a pretty pricey case. It's not even waterproof. It's just a regular, basic plastic case. With rubber, literally, it's a thick combination of both. And yeah, guys, that's about it. And peace out, guys, and I'll see you in another video, probably a gaming video, because I haven't done one in a bit of a while. And yeah, guys, peace.